Hello, hello, my name is Leo and welcome to Blauw Films. Today we're going to be looking at an example from Operation Deli Platter in which we made this night vision effect. In this video we're first going to cover the Corona VFB and get your night vision set up, and then we're doing some compositing inside of After Effects to really nail the look that you want. Alright, let's get into it. So, how do night vision goggles actually work? Night vision goggles are what you would call optoelectronic devices. What they do is they are basically image intensifiers. They're very different from what you would call thermal imaging, where you would actually be looking at heat signatures. With the standard night vision goggles, what you're looking at is a device that enhances the available ambient light and then converts near infrared light into visible light, which can then be seen by the user through the goggles. Now you might be asking, why is night vision actually green? Nowadays there are a variety of modern night vision systems that actually allow for some color information, but most of the times it converts the available light into a monochrome spectrum, which by then exposing it to a phosphor green plate gives you the classic monochrome green look. There's also a functional reason for it being green, as similar to the early computer screens, green was considered to be the easiest color to look at for prolonged periods of time when you're sitting in the dark. Alright, we're inside of Cinema 4D. Let's grab this night vision camera over here. You can immediately see we have an image aperture map inside of our depth of field. We have 0.5 on our bokeh vignetting, just to get some vignetting effect going. Sharpenings turned on, bloom and glare, tone mapping, settings. Now this is where most of the magic is going to happen. We have a corona light with a radius of 3 that we're placing right next to the camera, as you can see. We're going to be adding a few more lights later, but these are going to function as our infrared flashlights. I've set them to be at a directionality of 100% just to know where it's actually shining. If you see in our viewport, we can immediately see this really hot circular bright spot right there. You can actually turn off the infrared light right now. We have a LUT. We have the green magenta tint. If we set that to -1, we get it to purple. If we set it to 1, we get it to green. If we increase the shutter speed to 1000 and lower the f-stop to 0.8 and then try to play around with your ISO until you get a value that's strong enough. And then the final thing we have to do is to just lower as much of the brightness in your scene. Night vision will look completely blown out unless it's really dark. Slowly decreasing the directionality of our light, slowly flooding it a bit more. And here you go. Now we have 3 lights set around the camera, and that way we have kind of more, a little bit of a diversified infrared flashlight look. And we're going to go into projection mode and set the projection to fisheye. Now we have this fisheye field of view over here that's standardly set to 180. We actually want it to match what we have on our camera itself. So if you go there, you see field of view horizontal, it's about 40 degrees. So if we now go into our projection mode, set our fisheye to 40 degrees. There you go. Now, as you can see, we have a circular fisheye format. You can even set to enable VR mod to get your stereoscopic view. And then, you know, here, this is a really fun thing. This is the first step in defining the look that you want. If you're doing this the stereoscopic way, you can get this really fun effect that you have 2 eye sockets looking at you. But I'm actually going to set it to full frame, equidistant, and then try to make sure that it matches as much as possible what we had in our standard vision. I'm going to go up here into my multipass settings. I'm going to turn everything off, and I'm going to make sure we have Z depth enabled. Also make sure to enable multipass up top and enable multipass in your save settings. If I just quickly import that camera setup into a new scene with a few cubes inside of a cloner. The closer you get to your subject, the infrared flashlights giving you a whole lot of light output. You have a really nice fall off. I've actually made this night vision camera available, so just be sure to go to the link in the description below, blauwfilms.com. You can download this camera setup. Now we're inside of After Effects. created a new composition that I'm dragging this clip in. As you can see, the clip is actually quite small. I usually feel with night vision renders, you don't need to actually export at the resolution that your final output will be. Instead of scaling through the standard scale slider, you can actually hit Command Alt F. I'm gonna go in and create a new solid that we're gonna be matching with any of these green shades over here. What I'm trying to do is set it to multiply and eliminate most of the highlights that are white or maybe yellowish, and then just bring down the opacity. There you go. Now we're gonna go for an adjustment layer, and we're gonna add a color correction exposure effect. First, we're gonna be bringing down the gamma correction a bit, and then we're gonna be increasing the exposure just a smidge. What we're trying to do is reintroduce some of that contrast that we're looking for. I'm duplicating the bottom layer. Let's quickly rename the bottom to base. Rename this one to Z depth. Let me solo this, go to 3D channel, extractor. And then if you have 32-bit channels, your layer should just be there under layers. So here you go. Now we have our Z depth. And if we then create a new solid that's also green, just a slightly different green. Let me just move this one up, okay. If we then set the track mode to Z depth and luminance, we then have essentially created a luma mask out of our Z depth layer. We set it to overlay. You actually get a little bit of a harsh edge around the corner. So I am actually gonna go to soft light. It's a simple situation, right? If overlay doesn't work, usually soft light gets you what you want. Just quickly gonna make a few adjustments to the gamma correction. All right, now let's duplicate the Z depth, bring it up top, solo it out. And I'm dragging in this fire lens flare element from Action VFX. Duplicating the solid, setting it to color, increasing the opacity. And now we've made that fire lens flare layer green. I'm selecting the fire and the solid, pre-compose that, let's call it haze green, and then similarly to before, we're setting it to a luma track mat on the Z depth. And here you go, now you have that fire lens flare into the Z depth pass. If we set that to add, you can see what it does. You can just lower the opacity in a bit. I'm setting it to about 65. First, I'm duplicating it and setting the track mat to no track mat. And now we have that effect all over everything. Just bring that one down to 25 and the other one to 65% opacity. Select everything and pre-compose your layers. Let's call this green footage. This is our base now. Cool. Now let's start working on the actual look of it. Adjustment layer, let's call it ghosting. The cool thing is if you set an adjustment layer to lighten, it won't actually change anything on your effect. So by then going into distort and adding something like an optics compensation effect, check reverse lens distortion, set that to something like 10 or 12, and there you go. We're creating a little bit of a ghosting effect right around the edges of your clip. You set that a bit up, maybe 35 or something like that. There you go. Yeah, you can really see it now. Just bring down the opacity to about 25, and that way you're creating some kind of double glass bulging effect. Just to make sure it's a little bit softer. And I'm duplicating the ghosting effect and just setting a optics compensation down to about 10. Now the next thing I'd like to do is, we're gonna go to Layer, New, and one more adjustment layer. This time I'm gonna be creating an edge blur. I'm gonna be double clicking the ellipse tool mask. That way we have a nice ellipse over here. Double click that layer and then Alt Command drag to make a nice spherical vignette in the middle. Set it to subtract. I'm gonna be increasing the feather. Now this obviously is relative to the resolution of your screen. I'm adding a camera lens blur effect. The reason I like using camera lens blur, even though it's quite expensive on your rendering, is just because of how it interpolates the bokeh around the edges. I'm taking all those layers, compiling them again, pre-composing. And now let's create a little bit of chromatic aberration. I'm using a shift channel effect on the bottom duplicate. turning everything off except for taking the red channel from red, and we're repeating that for the top two layers, blue from blue, green from green, and turn everything off. Now by setting the top two layers to add, now we've essentially got the same image back. And then by taking the top two layers with an optics compensation effect and increasing that to about 9, we're just shifting a little bit of the edges to get some chromatic aberration. I'm using this really old video copilot asset of a lens just to give a little bit of darkness around the edges by multiplying it and then lightening the center and decreasing the opacity after turning it green, just to get a little bit more of detail as if we're looking through glass. This is completely optional, you don't need to do this. Now, I'm adding another adjustment layer. Let's call this Edge Fade. All right. Double click the ellipse tool like before, 200 pixel feather, set to subtract. And then what I like doing is using a CC radial blur, set to fading zoom with an amount of 1, 2, 3, something like that. And it just squishes out the edge pixels and really makes it feel as if there's some sphericality in your image. Now, making another adjustment layer, I'm just trying to pull these Beziers up and down a bit, bring it in, set to subtract, feather 250, and then with another camera blur, maybe set it to about 2, just trying to break up most of those details as they fade to the edge. And then let's bring the exposure down, the gamma, to about 0.95. One more adjustment layer. This is going to be a basic color correction. We're going to do that with levels. I'm going to try to bring in the left arrow over there all the way to the white spots. Finally, we're using some additional digital noise. You can use the standard noise inside of After Effects, but we have a pack called Digital Camera Noise, which has some really interesting noise patterns from the A7S, from the Blackmagic, from the Canon 70D, and they're super grungy and low quality, which for this situation is kind of perfect. I'm just applying one of those clips and setting it to soft light. As you can see, it kind of darkens the image. So we're gonna go color correction, curves, and if you take this top handle over here and just move it to the left on the top, we can kind of make sure that the brightness values get right. I'm duplicating that layer and I'm setting it to soft light again, making this one smaller in scale, and then duplicating it one more time, removing all the effects, and now we're going to try to really crunch one of these down, like really aggressively. Here you go. Let's call this displacement, bring it down a bit, and then we can add one more adjustment layer. You know what? Let's call this displacement. And let's call the top one displacement map. There you go. Now let's take the displacement layer, go to effect, distort, then displacement map, select the top layer, set it to lightness, and then as you can see, we can use our digital noise to create some additional distortion on top of our image. And as we know before, if we set the displacement layer to lighten, it won't actually affect the values. Look, and that's actually looking pretty good. Now the final thing I'd like to do is I'd like to add some white specks in there. And for that we have this digital fireflies asset that is also available on our store in the same digital noise pack. But anything that's just like really crunchy and has some white fireflies, you can just slap that on top. And here you go. This is what it looks like. Now that you've created this setup, you can very quickly go into Cinema 4D, drag the night vision camera into your scene, and make whatever render you want. Thank you very much for watching. thank you very much for sticking around with Blauw Films. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. Just leave a comment below. And if you're actually using a very different render engine, like Redshift, Octane, V-Ray, just let me know how you would approach this. I'm always excited to learn from you guys, and I hope you guys are learning some from this as well. If you're new here, welcome. Blauw Films is an IP development company. We make our original projects, we work with the people we like working with, and we're always trying to share as much as we can. Be sure to subscribe if you want to keep up to date with everything we do. I actually saw that most of you guys are not subscribed, so if you'd like to do that, that would greatly help us out. And, you know, thanks a lot, have a great day, and yep, that's it for me. Bye-bye.